Hi everybody, this is VSDC channel. Today we'll show you another animated intro tutorial, and if you like what you see, feel free to download this template from the description to the video. Without further ado, let's get started. Launch the editor and create a new project. Import a background image. If the image doesn't fit the size of the scene, just use the autocrop feature and set its duration at 3 seconds. Apply the grayscale effect from the adjustment section. Then apply the brightness contrast gamma effect. Set the contrast level at 50. Now add the zoom effect. And go to the Properties window. Find Levels and select Linear Parameter Change along a trajectory. Take a look at the graph now. You'll be working with the following control points: 0 point, 1 second, two seconds, 2.5 seconds, add a rectangle shape to the scene, and paint it orange. Switch the blending type to multiply. Place the rectangle right above the scene. And add a movement vector to it. Go to the Properties window and tweak a couple of parameters. Path start point, yes. Start speed, 0. Then manually set the beginning and the end of the movement vector on the timeline, somewhere between the first half a second and a second. Apply the zoom effect to the rectangle. Find levels and set linear parameter change along a trajectory. On the graph, you need to find the following control points: 0 point, 2 seconds. Place the cross to the top left corner, or just set the coordinates: 0, 0. Two and a half seconds. Three seconds. Now let's go back to the main timeline tab and add a headline. Convert the headline into a sprite. Then make a double click and place it a bit higher. Apply a movement vector to the headline you've just created. Notice, the headline movement should coincide with the movement of the orange rectangle. In the Properties window, make sure to set the following parameters. Path start point, yes. Start speed, 0. Again, it starts half a second after the beginning of the video. And it ends half a second later. Go back to the main timeline tab and check the following sprite properties. Use as container? No. Show effects? Yes. Fill background? No. Add a movement vector to the sprite. In the Properties window, set the following parameters. Path start point, yes. Start speed, 0. Again, the movement duration is very short here, from 2 seconds to 2 seconds and a half. Time to create a subhead. There we go. You'll also need to convert it into a sprite. And place the text slightly higher to the left. Now add a short movement vector to this piece of text as well. In the Properties window, set the following parameters. Path start point, yes. Start speed, 0. Its duration should last from 2 seconds to 2 seconds and a half. Go back to the main timeline tab and check the following sprite properties. Use as container? No. Show effects? Yes. Fill background? No. That's it. Remember, you can download this intro template using the link in the description. And thank you for watching. Don't forget to subscribe.